And before we get to your calls, 410-338-1098, give us some interesting Eastern holistic medicines. I want to jump to the phones real quick. I do. Congratulations. I do have a winner. It is John from Nottingham. Congratulations. You won today's prize, my friend. It's a twofer. You got a double pack here. An Arctic 24-ounce double insulated bottle with that 98 Rock logo proudly engraved across it, as well as some custom 98 Rock sunglasses, my friend. And you are in the running.
Awesome.
For $5,000 in May. Scott, ask him what we've been asking him.
What are you going to buy me with your $5,000?
Yeah, what are we getting?
What are you going to buy me?
Us, them.
Might go to the dispensary, get some holistic medicine, and maybe I can get there for you guys.
Get new weed.
Smoke weed every day.
Yeah.
Weed. Stay off the weed.
How many edibles can you buy with $5,000?
A lot.
Oh, my God. A ton.
Okay, good
Don't
for you.
Curse.
You almost did.
You almost
did.
Said a S. I got you.
Yes.
Hey, what's your favorite flavor? What do you dabble in? What do you like?
Bodega bubble gum.
Bodega bubble gum. You coming thing. With that bodega?
Bodega bubble gum.
Bodega.
It's gonna get you feeling fine. Again.
Well, good luck. Hopefully, you win the $5,000.
Yeah, you deserve it. Complete rules, details, 98online.com/contest. After everything has been paid out, you run right over to Curio Wellness, slap 5 cool ones on the counter, and say, "I'll get some of that bodega bubble gum."
Hey, look, he's not far off. Right here we go. This is a plant that grows out of the ground. You pick it, you hang it, you dry it, you eat it, you smoke it. It increases your appetite. It chills out your brain. It makes you feel better. It's sometimes helpful with cancer patients. This is medicine from the earths. It's not in a pill. It's not some laboratory, some white coat dude with goggles on.
Yeah, it's nothing that's been synthesized, chemically strained, developed in some weird ice cold lab. The earth. And the one that I tried yesterday, you heard me bring it up on the air. I get headaches. I've been trying to ride them out. I probably have CTE, and it hasn't been looked into. It's one of the reasons I probably get a nosebleed twice a day. But I get headaches, and I read that mint oil, mint extract, or even just mint leaves themselves can help with a headache. And I tend to get headaches when the barometric pressure gets a little high. It did yesterday, right before it rained. And we got this weird bumper crop of mint in our backyard garden. This stuff grows like a weed. And I did it. I grabbed a wad of it. I chewed it. I packed a lip. It was tart. Let me tell you that. It tasted like mint, but it tasted like mint mixed with a little bit of bird. It was a tough chew. And I want to tell myself that it worked. I feel like it did. Let me ask you this. This is almost a philosophical question. If it works, but it's a mind over matter thing where it's almost a placebo effect where I convinced myself it worked. Does that not technically still mean it worked?
Means you're gullible.
Yeah, I'm a dummy. I'm easily
tricked
by advertising.
Yeah, I don't know. There's got to be some sort of physical effect, not just a mental effect.
I feel like it helped. Now, it didn't knock it out like an Excedrin, but I feel like it lessened.
You know what made me think of this a lot was I watched Alone. I think it was Alone on Netflix. It's the History Channel show where they just drop people out in the wild and they have to survive. And a lot of these people are hardcore survivalists.
Mm-hmm.
And they know how to use the land around them.
Yes.
Whether it be for killing an animal to eat it or getting a water source. But it also, they know which plants have medicinal value. If you burn yourself, what to put on a burn. If you have an upset stomach, eat this. It'll cure your nausea. And these are real plants that are out in the wild that these survivalists actually know do these things. This is not some sort of placebo effect. It's not psychosomatic. There are ingredients in these plants that you can use. And it's, I don't know. I was doing the turmeric. I really believe turmeric helps with swelling and helps your body and digestion. I was doing apple cider vinegar, honey, and turmeric for a while. And I don't know. I just stopped. You don't know if it works.
Yeah, but would you consider fish oil holistic? Because I've been taking omegas. I've been taking Kenny omegas, and they're still in a pill, but it's a gel cap, and the goop is in there. The fish goop. Does that count? An omega?
I guess.
I'm still buying it off of a shelf. Do you know who knows about this stuff? Jessica in Towson on line one. You grew up in a holistic household. No medicines, no over-the-counter type of stuff. This was how you lived, Jessica.
Well, so, yeah, my household was slightly a little bit more accepting of, like my mother was, but I had come from a long line of chiropractors.
Okay.
And from my great-grandfather all the way down to all of my uncles. And there are, most of them have never taken an aspirin. They don't, they haven't gotten any type of vaccinations. My grandmother, who is 85, and people think she's in her 60s, as young as she looks and how much she travels, has never had a vaccination. And she's never been in the hospital with anything serious. Wow. And one of the things that we grew up on is, aside from like taking regular like vitamin C, calcium, things like that, garlic pills, and you know, eating garlic, of course, Scott being Italian, I'm sure garlic is in everything
you
make,
which is,
it's good for a ton of things. But if you take the condensed garlic vitamins, they're like supplements, they do wonders for your immune system. And my grandmother has taken them. I've taken them, like my mom, we all take them, you know, every single night, and we're very rarely sick. And it's just there's a lot of things that you can do. Yes. So yes, I will say, depending on how porous your body is, you can smell like garlic.
If you go to the gym or you go run it, it'll like,
ooze out of your pores. And I will tell you though, if you take it and you don't really smell it, and then there's like a day that you're like, why do I smell like garlic? Oh my God, your wife's like, you reek. It's because your body is fighting something.
Is there anything out there in nature I can just rip a handful out of the ground and just either shove it behind my crotch or eat it, and I don't have to?
Yeah. Yeah, I know what it's being a man.
Oh,
hey.
God, he just got me day one. He's already back. And I'm already catching it. No, seriously, is there anything in the woods?
Oh, I miss you, Spiegel. Miss you.
Thank you.
The survival thing is, like, I know you can eat tree bark. That's about it. I don't know. I don't do nature, so I'm not sure about all that. But there's plenty of, like, Justin, you said mint. Mint is wonderful for headaches. There's, essence of oregano is something you can get, which is very, very potent.
It sounds like a perfume for hippies. Essence of oregano. Memory of basil, thoughts of time. Let's go to who we got here. Is that what's that say? Does that say Poppy? Am I looking at Poppy?
Hey.
What's up?
Hey, how y'all doing?
Good. We're looking for some homeopathic cures. We're done with the pills and the stuff.
I follow a guy who calls himself Motivational Dr. Mandel on YouTube. He's into pressure culture, homeopathic cures, and he's an amazing man. And he has everything you could possibly need to figure out what's the best thing for you to do for your headache.
Like, give me an example of something he's taught. Like, let's just say I got joint pain. What's Dr. YouTube telling me?
Well, he's talking about taking different recipes that I can't name off the top of my head, but you can find his different videos, and he basically lists what it is you're trying to figure out to do. He's got videos that'll have that topic listed. But one of the things that I discovered from him is you can take your thumb and push it into the bridge of your nose between your forehead and your nose, and you put pressure on that for like 35, 40 seconds or so. I mean, really excessive pressure, and it'll help you sleep, and it'll help with headaches.
Wow.
Like in the same position, like when a kid would fart in elementary school and you'd put your hand on your forehead, and whoever didn't do it ate it. Anybody else play that game?
No.
No one else did that? No one else ever played the game where if someone tooted, you had to put your hand on your forehead like that, and the last kid to do it ate the fart?
No.
Oh, God, was I the only one?
I didn't do that.
Oh, God. Please tell me someone else.
Coming up.